Lebanese writer Khalil Gibran once said that trees are the poems that the earth writes upon the sky. Good morning, dear students. It's time for your science class. Let's try to listen to these beautiful poems of nature together and learn more about plants today. We have already studied in this lesson that there are many types of plants in our surroundings. There are two basic parts of a plant, root and shoot. Root is usually found below the ground. It is the first part to grow out of a seed. It plays an important role in the functioning of a plant as it fixes the plant to the soil and absorbs water and nutrients from the ground. Some roots store food for their plants. Now talking about the shoot, it is classified into stem, leaves, flowers and fruits. Stem grows upwards from the roots and helps the plant to stand straight. It works as the transport system of the plant. Some stems are modified to store food also. After talking about the root and the stem of the plant, let's move forward and learn about leaves. Children, as you already know, leaves are an important part of the shoot system of the plant. And you can easily identify a plant by its leaves. Like, everybody knows that this is Ashoka tree. And this one is a rose shrub. You can see different types of leaves in different types of plants. In fact, you can easily identify a plant by its leaves. Leaves of one plant may look very different from the other, but their function remain the same. They are very important for a plant as they are responsible for preparing food for it. So children, if we compare root of a plant with the foundation of a building and stem with its walls, then it is appropriate to call leaves the kitchen of a plant, because this is the place where food for the plant is prepared. You have already studied that all living things need food for their growth. Plants are also living things, just like you and me. And they too need food for their growth. Your mother cooks food in her kitchen with the help of some ingredients. But where do the plants cook food? And what are the ingredients that they use? Well, children, water, air and sunlight are the ingredients which are used by the leaves to cook food for the plant, as leaves are the food factory or the kitchen of the plant. Now we have understood how important leaves are for a plant. Let's know more about them and learn about their structure. The leaf has a flat structure. The stalk of a leaf is called the petiole. The flat and broad part is called the lamina or the leaf blade. You must have observed that leaves are usually green in color. Do you know the reason behind it? Well, leaves look green because they contain a pigment called chlorophyll that helps in preparing food. The process of making food by the leaf for the plant is called photosynthesis. Leaves may or may not be of the same shape, size and color, but all leaves have a single long line running from the center of the leaf. The central line is called the midrib. The other lines that branch out the midrib are called leaf veins. The surface of a leaf has minute pores called stomata. Through stomata, plants take and release air. Plants also lose their excess water through stomata. The stomata can be seen through a microscope in a lab. You already know that leaves need some ingredients to prepare food for the plant. And these ingredients are sunlight, air and water. But do you know some leaves are used to make your food also? Yes, children, I'm talking about these leaves. These leaves are everyone's favorite because they are good for health. Children, some plants store their food in their leaves. Lettuce, cabbage and spinach are examples of such leaves.
So now we know that leaves are the kitchen of the plant and they play an important role in its functioning. Before we wind up today's class, let's take a quick recap of whatever we have learned today.
We have learned today that different plants have different types of leaves. We can easily identify a plant by its leaves. Even though leaves of different plants have different shapes and sizes, they have a common structure. A leaf is made up of different parts. These are the leaf blade, petiole, midrib, veins, and stomata.
The flat and broad part of the leaf is called the leaf blade or lamina. The leaf blade is attached to the stem of the plant through a tiny stalk called the petiole. A thin line runs from the center of a leaf towards its tip. This is the central vein, also known as the midrib. There are numerous tiny lines that run throughout the leaf. They are called veins. All these veins, along with the midrib, provide shape and support to the leaf. A number of tiny openings are present on the surface of a leaf. These tiny openings are called stomata. They help the plant in exchange of gases and release of excess water. You must have observed that most leaves are green in color. It is because of a pigment called chlorophyll. It helps the plant in preparing food. The leaf plays an important role in the functioning of a plant. It is known as the kitchen of the plant as it makes food for the plant with the help of water, air and sunlight in the presence of chlorophyll. This process is called photosynthesis. Leaf helps in exchange of gases and release of water through small pores called stomata. In some plants, leaf stores food also. For example, spinach, cabbage and lettuce. So now we know that a leaf is made up of different parts such as leaf blade or lamina, petiole, midrib, veins and stomata. Leaves are responsible for making food for the plant. They help the plants in exchange of gases and release of excess water. In some plants, leaves store food also.
Children, have you ever wondered what would happen to a plant if its leaves are removed? Then, food for the plant would not be prepared. The exchange of gases would not take place and excess water would not be released. In such a case, plant would not be able to survive. So next time, if you see someone plucking the leaves of a plant unnecessarily, stop them from doing so.
I hope you enjoyed learning about the food factory of the plant leaf today. We shall meet again very soon to learn about the other parts of the plant. Till then, keep befriending the plants in your surroundings. Bye-bye.